to prepare ourselves for observation as engineers, we had boot camp here, which had tons of clinical lectures to prepare us for the kinds of things we would see. But I would say I did a lot of reading online for different procedures.
I think the lessons learned is you really need to do your homework before you go into the observation phase. You can do like quick search on YouTube to see how the operation is done, what kind of processes to have a better understanding before you go into the OR, so you can ask smarter questions. Just don't be afraid of asking when you feel the moment is right. Most of the surgeons are wonderful. They are really helpful answering your questions, even though at the beginning we asked a lot of stupid questions, and it really did help us learning.
Our team had 4 people total. We have 3 engineers, 2 biomedical, 1 mechanical, and then a clinician. And so when we went into needs finding, we usually did it in pairs in the beginning, I think, to kind of get ourselves used to it. And it was also helpful to be with the clinician because he could explain a lot of things. But then once we got comfortable, we often did it alone because sometimes it's easier and more comfortable for the patient and the physician that you're shadowing to just be one person rather than this army of people watching them do their work.
What really helped to me in the observation part was to write everything down on a notebook, irrespective of whether it's actually going to be into a need or not. Because at that point in time, if you start thinking about those things, you might actually miss a lot of stuff that's happening around. So whatever you see, hear, feel, whatever you sense, just write it down in a piece of notebook. Come back. Think, why does that happen that way? It's always good to draw besides that on your notebook what you're seeing, because sometimes you need to get back what was there, what was not there.
For observation capturing, we use just notebooks. It's much easier to scribble something really quickly while someone's talking in the clinic there, but then we all transferred them to a more electronic form. So we used spreadsheets, and a Google spreadsheet was actually really helpful because then we could all update it at the same time. And so we used a format of, you know, problem or observation, and then the need we'd write about it, and then we left space also for the different filtering categories we were going to use.
One of the things they told us is that go for quantity over quality, and I definitely think that that is true, because even if you think something is dumb or not that significant an observation, you should write it down because later you might be able to pivot from it to another need. I think there's a few times we came up with one need that sounded sort of not that interesting, but once we sort of looked at the root of the problem or thought about different aspects of that problem, we came up with a really great need.
In the beginning, as you know, a newbie to this process, you write down everything and anything. I think as needs finding goes on, you start to really hone in on what's a good need. And so, you know, in the beginning, I would write down like 50 problems a day, but you know, after a week, I was writing down only like 4 or 5 good problems that I saw. We met probably every other day in the afternoon after doing needs finding in the morning, and we'd each put our findings into a table format and then discuss them as a group. Sometimes, you know, you would see repeat observations, so then you could either add to it and say like, oh, here's another problem I saw with that same procedure, or you could say, okay, we covered that one. So it was helpful to understand also the frequency with how often some of these things happen.